heavy static. Heavy static is obviously a very distant signal that you guys are picking up. In the background, you hear Rancor scream, another huge clash of a droid being slammed against the wall. Maharaja.
Yeah, I see that he's trying to do that. I'm going after him to get that remote control.
Okay.
He doesn't have his droids around.
Oh, that's a good idea. Okay. That would be slightly treasonous. Because he's technically in charge. On the other hand, things have gone completely insane and you're out, well outside of like...
When freedom is outlawed, only outlaws will be free, man.
Yeah, you're well outside of the... You're just in the middle of outer space. So what happens on this ship right now is up to you guys. But when the next time you get into Republic space, for the next time the Republic tries to get in touch with the sergeant who's been sent along with you, things might get messy.
And you no longer have a master of disguise to impersonate him, so...
Gippy was a master of disguise. Let the records show that I did air quotes.
But I'm very coercive with it, though. Ooh, and like, I'm on your side. Let me hold this.
Make a coercion check.
Okay.
Opposed by your discipline check.
Discipline check. Okay, so my discipline is not great. It's two green, so that's two purple.
I've got two green for
Two green against two purple, because we're doing an opposed check. Ooh, I've got, is it all black? Yeah, I better flip one of those over, so we're going to make one of those a red.
Oh, goodness. I just wanted to get the remote.
You want to see this? It's pretty cool. I can show it to you.
Yeah.
I mean,
it would be a good idea to give me that.
I'm thinking about it.
Ooh. Reroll.
No.
Reroll.
She's spending her reroll on you. If you choose to accept it, and you can reroll that entire roll. That is the power of the reroll.
I do the reroll.
Can she also spend a light side point?
I think we should cheers the use of a reroll. Reroll!
Should I use one of the white chips?
You absolutely can if you want to, yeah.
I need to balance this out, so I'm going to use one of the white chips.
Do it.
We're going to get this remote.
Get that remote.
We're getting this remote.
You guys are going to just sit in a circle and
the rest of the trip.
You guys are both naturals at this game. I'm totally impressed. How quickly you pick this up.
You really want to give me that remote because... Okay.
Was that a failure again? It is.
It is, but with...
One advantage.
One advantage.
Two advantage.
I'm not going to give it to you. I'm just going to say this does this and this does this.
I'll be your bodyguard since your droids are gone now. You need that, right?
Oh, thank God. Save me from that weird little furry thing and her friend.
Quit screwing around back there.
Okay, roll a boost die and add that onto there because that was persuasive. Just add it into that pile and we'll see if it's a success that works. No, so it gives you an additional advantage, but he's going to hang on to his remote.
But you trust me, right?
Listen, you have way more military experience than I do. I mean, like, you know, the Navy, you know how it goes. Anyway, just, I mean, like, if you have a suggestion of what I should do in terms of pushing these buttons here, I don't remember what they all do. Just kind of remember. The red one seems bad.
So, not the red.
You guys trust each other. I'm kind of over to you. Yes, sir.
Both of the droids are inside of the room with the...
The Rancor is keeping them both occupied.
And no one else is in the room?
This is in... The Ewok's little quarters in the ship.
Right, but the Ewok is not in.
Ewok is not in that room, that's right.
Okay, I'm going to calmly get up and walk over to where the button is and lean against it.
The comm button?
The button to close the door. I'm sorry.
Closing them into her room?
Oh, you're walking to lock her room.
Yeah, I'm just going to just do that, like, what's going on back here?
So you lean onto the button, shuts the door and locks it?
Yes.
Locking the Rancor into your room with the two droids?
Yeah.
Ooh, those clinging sounds do not sound good for me. Sounds like someone maybe has somebody by the ankles and is slamming their head over and over and over against the wall, so the door like shaking.
Yeah.
Thank you. You're my other bodyguard.
You said
here's a reward.
You said you calmed it up.
Green equals kill, apparently. I don't know why they would do that. Sorry.
Let's not push any more buttons now.
Okay.
The comm comes live as you get.
Crew of the Hertz? Crew of the Hertz? Is anyone there?
It's a very familiar voice to possibly you and possibly you. Here's a story arc that doesn't pay off.
It's me, Bosley Mathis.
Yes, maybe some of you longtime viewers have any idea who that is. Probably not.
Bosley Mathis?
Yeah, that was before you started playing, and he was absent the game that you were playing.
Okay.
I mean, you two are new.
Yeah.
So, this doesn't make much sense, and it doesn't mean hardly anything to you. So, it's just a name.
Okay.
Just a name as far as you guys are concerned. You guys gotta help me out. Again, heavy static. Hard to make out. It's Tamaya. Tamaya, she's got some sort of plans. I'm sending coordinates to your guys' ship. You gotta help me out. Crew of the Hertz, please. He did spend time on the ship, so that seems to be, you guys wouldn't know this, but why he would have your communication contact. Second, Sergeant Johnst would know who Bosley Mathis probably is.
Who is Bosley Mathis?
You have access to classified technology. He is the, and this funnily kind of ties into Rogue One a little bit, he is the primary engineer on the Death Star laser.
Is?
Was.
Was.
Because the last time anybody saw him, he seems like he had died.
Gotcha.
Okay.
All right. Yeah, this guy's Bosley Mathis, geez. It's like, don't buy anything that guy's selling you if it has an exhaust port. Know what I'm saying?
not the actual Death Star plans overall. That, as we all know, is Matt Mickelson, but yes. Just the laser portion, the super laser.
The super laser. Okay, just the super laser.
Yeah, he was from Alderaan as well.
Oh, really? Ooh, bit of irony there.
Yeah, and that was for you guys who don't know who that is. That was Grov's original character before he turned into Grango. Yeah.
Oh, all right.
Yeah, he saved Life Day. Episode 2, Saving Life Day.
So I'll modify that statement to, you know, it's just like, don't trust this guy with your home world. I don't know. Anyway.
So it's important to point out, engineer of Death Star Laser, probably close to public enemy number one on, like, people the Republic would like to, like, track down and get back. Presumed dead. Seemingly broadcasting something live to your ship right now.
Although Trump of the Hutt keeps saying great things about him on his Twitter account.
Brilliant engineering. Made a laser, blew up his own planet. Brilliant guy.
Shows, yeah, real follow through.
Oh, wow.
He seems to have the personal line to the ship of the guys who are already slightly implicated with treasonous activities. Not good. But the comlink cuts out.
Do we get the coordinates on that?
I don't know.
You sent it to the ship, right?
Busy goofing off back here, and
goofing
I had to
off?
Come.
I was doing my...
Let's see if you did get the coordinates. So it sounds like you were the most on the comm when that was coming through.
Really?
Give me a computer's check to see how much of it successfully came through. It's going to be... let's say 3 purple.
Oh,
because it was really staticky, but you were also not in the cockpit for most of that, so I'm going to give you 1 setback die. Yeah, throw that in there. That's the one, the black one.
Because everyone's too busy goofing off back there.
That's a failure. There's a,
is that one cocked on the side?
There's a success.
It is cocked, but it's a success.
Right, so let's re-roll it if it's on its side, huh?
It's not
That's a success.
Oh, players. Okay. I'll rule in your favor. It is a success. So is it's still a failure,
but it's still
though,
a failure.
Huh? Okay. Yeah. With one threat?
Yep.
Okay. No, so you go back. You get back to your comm thing.
Sorry, I'm new at this. I was like, wait, those cancel each other out.
You guys are doing great. You're picking this up so much more quickly than...
Yeah, no, because I see the threats, but I can take these out because they cancel each other out, right?
Yeah, they do.
That helps me.
Do it.
For sure.
Take these
those
out,
two will cancel.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, great.
So
thank
if there's
you.
No successes left over,
yeah,
it's a failure.
Okay.
So you get back to the comm, you go back to the bridge, you hit the button, and... starts reading out the complex GPS style coordinate that stops like 90% of the way through.
Oh, goodness.
The last like 3 digits are missing. Mm. That narrows it down. You can punch into your astrogation computer. Little map of the galaxy projects holographically. Narrows it down to this pretty much empty area of space here.
This is just not enough information. My ship is much more detailed.
Oh my goodness. I could probably run a probability matrix through my data pad to
computer.
You know.
Do that. Which one of these buttons does
no,
that?
No, no, none
one?
Of the buttons. None
oh,
of the buttons.
Sorry.
No, it's fine. Hey, you're doing a great job. You're a real good leader.
I agree.
Yeah. You're just knocking it out of the park.
You keep doing you.
And then the smells of the man's corpse that you were eating.
I didn't shoot you. It wasn't me. It was me, but it wasn't me. Get over it.
I'm at the door, like, saying, don't touch the posters!
Yeah, the door's still locked shut.
Yeah, it's still locked shut, and you're still
there. The clinging has kind of stopped and is dying down now. Clang, 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 clang.
Me? I knock on the door. It's like, listen, I won't touch your posters anymore. I think we've all got a little bit of a peace treaty going on here. There's still at least a quarter of a rump left. Do you want to split it with me?
You're saying that to the Ewok?
Yes, yeah, the Ewok. Rancor?
Oh.
Okay.
Swamp.
Door opens up again.
Is Yerp out of his?
And your room is pretty much trashed.
But that's honestly.
But he knew not to touch the posters?
He didn't touch the posters. That's
yeah, so the other posters are okay, but everything else.
Gippy had already smashed my bed.
Yeah. Yes.
Wait, were my hydroponics in here?
Oh, that's right. And I probably should have mentioned that before.
Oh no, your weed?
Probably some weed growing in there, some natural herbs.
Some weeds.
When you came into some money from your gladiator fighting, Root did, she spent it all to put like a complex system of basically hanging plants with water to fill it.
Makes it
so
more
the whole
like
place
home.
Is filled with greenery and plants and stuff that grow and nice and it's watered. Yeah.
Well, what actual heaven should have been, I guess.
Yeah. So you have these coordinates. If you want to do a computer's check, that will give me a boost on the astrogation check that I need to try and figure out what these last three digits are. If you do well on your astrogation check, you're going to pop into that system at the correct coordinates. If you do badly on the astrogation check, your ship is going to have a rough arrival. Depends on how bad we're doing.
I don't know why you keep saying your ship. This is not my ship.
It's no one's ship here.
My ship is significantly better.
The New Republic ship is going to have a rough arrival. But the current occupants may not be happy with it.
Listen, Bosley's a bad guy, okay? But the friend of my enemy is still my enemy, but might be my friend for some reason. So if you're all following me, you may not be, but I think we should go straight for wherever those coordinates lead. It makes as much sense as every other policy this guy has, so who cares? can I roll leadership again to give everybody a boost on this?
That sounds really good.
By bashing buttons on my remote?
That seems to be what he's great at.
Okay.
So it's two leadership.
Not actually persuasive? Okay.
No. And it's clear that. Can you clear those two dice, please?
Got it.
Thank you.
Yeah, sure. Could you help me out with another yellow, please?
Yes. And then after that, let's do a computer's check. Just two purple for you to see if you can. A triumph.
Okay.
And a success!
Yes.
Whoa.
Barely.
Barely, because the triumph counts as one success.
So my triumph is like I accidentally like push like the level select code on like the controller here. So it's like up, down, left, right, start, select.
Cheat code.
Yeah, and
what's that do?
So basically what that does is it gives everybody a boost on their next roll.
You push start before you push select. Select is how you go down to more play.
Oh, okay, sorry. I have a game designer here, like I can't really argue with it. So as far as a triumph is concerned?
So everyone gets a boost from your success, from the raw success. I don't know.
It injects like a ton of chemicals into the corpse of Gippy, which causes all of his eggs to hatch.
He's got eggs?
I thought he was a man.
The undevoured ones.
Oh, goodness.
This is becoming horrifying. Newborn young start spilling out of the corpse you were eating?
Are they all gimpies? Do they, like, have his consciousness?
Yes. No. I feel it's kind of like, they go into a battle royale. Shark babies.
Oh my gosh.
There's not enough information on Mom Pals. You can't tell me I'm wrong.
wait a minute. I have an alternative way to get a Gippy back into the narrative.
I'm not trying to get Gippy the narrative.
No, go ahead. No.
Not without the body horror. Fine.
Not right now, I don't. Not right now, I don't. So, if you want to describe how the babies are fighting each other to the death?
Oh yeah, my goodness.
They consume each other until there's only one left, who's the fattest of all of them. And
oh. The captain just puts it up and puts it
in. Delicious.
It is all the bones.
No, goodness. I'm sorry. I don't mean to interrupt. Tell me for goodness. Real. What happens when the okay, there's so one fat
there's one baby Gippy fat left. Baby Gippy left, and it kind of like moseys off towards the hot tub, and like goes to its natural habitat, which is luxury.
What has happened?
No. Rolled a triumph on a leadership role and used it to maybe cause we'll Gippy's that. Eggs to hatch.
Yeah, but we all got it like a that's we all got a bonus. We all got a bonus on our next roll.
So perhaps we'll pick up that thread next week.
Anyway. Do any of these holy eggs hatch cow. In someone's belly?
No.
Good.
No.
They've enough. Already been eaten, actually.
Yeah, you're enough of that. So.
So computer.
And it's all rendered in horrible CG. Isn't that like Star Wars first
no.
like Phantom Menace CG level, where they're just like, meh. None of them are casting shadows. It's bizarre.
Yeah, it's that or like. Cronenberg's Naked Lunch. Take your pick. Like,
yep.
Anyway, that's for nobody. So,
as you all manage to hold down your food, I guess.
I don't have a problem with this.
You finish compiling your data on your pad. So I'm going to need a computer's check from you against okay. two purple to see how that goes. There's a real mismatch in styles.
Goodness.
On the table.
There's one extra yellow still floating around in there.
Okay. Oh, thank you, thank you.
It's just so funny to move between the two of you.
You said two purple?
So you're essentially standing over this corpse as like the young are like killing each other. Like one baby gets up and like walks off towards the jacuzzi and you're like, plus three.
Yeah, like I've okay. seen worse, yeah. much worse.
Oh God.
But he said, like, with his leadership thing that we have
you get a boost.
A boost.
Okay.
So it definitely applies to this.
Okay.
Are you, who's preparing the astrogation check out of the two of you? Two green.
I beat you.
They're going to need your boost here.
Okay.
So I have I'm a yellow and a green.
Oh, well, that's good. All right, so.
All right.
Wow.
Raja.
That's great.
Oh,
nice.
That's great, yeah. So that's one, two, three. Three successes.
One threat.
And one threat. Great, so three successes and a threat. Okay. No problem, three successes. I'm gonna give you guys two boost die.
Snaps!
That sounds good.
Okay.
Threat.
Can I clear these?
Yeah, you can go ahead and clear them. Yeah, your threat in this case is that.
Take a strain doing it?
Yeah, you take a strain. So take one strain. You just mark down your strain.
Okay.
Go down by one okay. because your data pad is stuck compiling this information for a long time. You're not going to be able to use it for anything else for some period of time. It's like you get like a
thought something like that would happen.
Out of yeah. memory error is like, or like oh
it's like,
man,
darn it, this yeah, is going to take forever to defrag.
It's a last gen data pad. Yeah, you're totally screwed on it. So that cuts back, but you're able to send that info back to the cockpit.
Okay.
Okay.
One of you sit in the pilot seat. I feel like that's you. One of you is punching in astrogation information into the complex nav computer. Is that the Ewok?
That's me. I have a better stats than he does.
Wonderful. How do you conceptualize that in game for an Ewok to be able to comprehend?
What it is, because I've done this before.
You have, haven't you?
I have. Is that the Ewok has created constellations. Like, the Ewok sees a star map and has created constellations to understand it. Because that's how she would understand these things in the past.
So you pull up the star map and you're like, there's the big rodeo.
Uh-huh.
There's the drunken rancor.
Uh-huh.
Okay. And like you like, you're like, we just have to yeah. fly between the dog's armpit and uh-huh. land on the snake's mouth, and that's yep. where we go.
Can mm-hmm. I say I would love to see that fan fiction of just like Ewok constellations?
Yes.
Yeah. They're okay. myths.
So unfortunately, because we didn't get the complete information, it's going to be two red and a purple is your difficulty.
And ooh. We're supposed to have two extra die for this roll?
Two boost die, one from her computer that's like crunching.
Mm-hmm. One from
two from your computer crunching because you did it so well.
Right.
And one from him, so you actually have three boost die.
Do we want to use one of the last white chips to balance out some of those reds?
I'm going to say yes.
I'm game.
Okay. We flip that over. I cheers to the dark side. Hurrah! Oh,
the dark side.
The dark side.
Oh, goodness.
Darkness grows. Oh. Okay, and you prepare for this roll. So you punch it in. So this is in the pilot seat. You glance back at the Ewok.
Yeah, the other one shot me.
Slowly punching in the coordinates. And you realize you're the one who has to hit the hyperdrive button that she's coordinating. And then whatever you come out into, you better be ready for it.
All right.
Okay. All right.
All right.
This is two red, a purple, versus two yellow, and three boost die.
Okay.
Let's all give this roll some good karma, everybody. If you'd all lay some karma on this, thank you, karma. Karma.
Good karma.
Not you?
Hex!
No!
Oh, no!
Protect it from his hex!
Oh, my hex succeeded?
What? It is a success.
Ooh. Oh. Three success against two failures, so that's a total of one success, as far as I can see.
Okay, these cancel out.
Okay.
Your ship jumps out of hyperspace in a distant star system, a vast area of space.
These cancel out?
With a single large research station floating out in the darkness.
It's
Do you
success.
Have threat or advantage? Two advantage.
Two advantage and a success.
Yes.
Dang. Easy approach as you come out of the hyperspace.
Yes, I'm an Ewok.
Good right. job, y'all. You deserve a reward.
No, there are no buttons.
As you come jumping out real close to the dock and easy approach, outside of this big research-looking space station, it looks like two big metal cones kind of squidged together in the middle with a starfish kind of sticking out, kind of radiating out from it. All made out of kind of used to be shiny metal at some point. Mm. And it probably gleamed like a Christmas tree when it was all lit up. But as you guys approach it, 70% of the lights seem to be out, at least. Normally you'd have like a couple like beacons blinking off on the top, and those are both out. There seem to be some interior lights. That's about it.
So we can dock quite easily.
No traffic around here, certainly, as you come in. Although, as you guys come closer, you can see one of the docking bays, the first one you approach, the nearest one to you, is normally you would get some sort of like warning, like if there's a problem. No warning, so it seems to be fine, but as you get closer, it's all jammed up with smashed up starships that were some sort
this
of collision.
Excuse me? I run back into my gunnery.
Get down. You fly around to the next docking bay. This one seems to be open. There is like a small personal craft that's like slowly spinning and like bumping up against a corner.
And other than that, lights are missing.
This docking bay's probably got most of its lights on, but there seems to have been a power outage in across most of the station.
This is your captain speaking. I just want to let you all know, on my ship, I purposely keep a backup of lights just in case something like this happens. Makes a good amount of money.
Would you be back in the co-pilot seat?
Yeah.
Okay, so you probably have comm controls if you want to try and raise anybody in there.
Okay. Spaceport. That wasn't me. permission to dock, and it looks like...
Static on all channels. Try channel after channel.
Okay, well, this doesn't look good. I've got a bad feeling about this.
that's gotta give you like a boost or something like that, right?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Whoever successfully uses that in any given second gets a boost. That's delightful. Okay. You should have a bad feeling about this. I think that's pretty clear.
I have a bad feeling about this.
Don't push buttons.
Not anymore, you won't.
So yeah, in fact, you guys probably would just pull out and fly away if you didn't have a seemingly insane sergeant breathing down your necks.
I'm not crazy. I could just kill you all at any moment with the press of a button. No, apparently nobody's taking it from me despite me not having any droids.
Long Good. Shot. Long shot of.
I've already lost that role.
As your finger hovers, as your finger hovers over the kill everyone button.
Yeah.
Long shot of the
I'm
ship.
I'm great at this. I'm a great leader.
Into the docking port. ship comes down. The steam shoots out as the landing ramp descends. So this is like, imagine, it's probably very much like Imperial docking facility where you've got like that giant electrostatic wall that you guys have just come through. But it's extremely dark in here. Like everything's been powered down.
Wait, we got off of the ship already?
No, I'm just describing what it looks like.
Okay.
But you have landed successfully. Seems to be dead as a tomb. In one corner, there's like a ship that just seems to be unattended. Looks like there's probably one big opening doorway, sliding door that leads into the depths of the facility. Okay. You're currently on the ship. But whatever it is, whoever sent that message to you, if it was Bosley Mathis, a man who should be dead, came from somewhere in this facility.
I'm readying my equipment, my blaster carbine, and getting my assortment of knives ready. You know,
great,
like...
we get a little montage of the gearing up. There you go. Gun, knives, grenades.
Controls.
Rope.
Rope.
Rocks. Slingshots.
Val leans down and he kisses the control panel. It's okay, little boy. We'll be right back.
I guess this ship is growing on you. Question.
Comments the Ewok to herself.
Yeah. I guess this ship is growing on you like monsters on my... Hydroponics!
I knew it was making you feel better about this ship.
Val, does he have weapons that he's coming off the ship
with? He only has a blaster pistol.
Low slung at the hip?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, sounds good.
Do you also have a thing of, was it Paps? Well, no, malt liquor.
Works every time.
Root.
Is there life support and gravity in this station?
Seems like the life support and gravity is currently in effect.
you guys are already out there. It's like, whoops.
No. You get all the system readings and everything like that. Okay.
You said there was one ship that was sort of bouncing around. That's outside? Mm.
It must have been, it's just outside the docking.
And the other, so there's a different ship that's in here with us?
Yeah, that probably has not been.
And it's
just sitting there in
sitting
the
there? Does it look like it's been there a long time? Does it look like signs of age, broken windows?
Give me an education check.
I'm not educated.
Or knowledge, for general knowledge. Whoever wants to make that check, we can do that.
About what?
General knowledge?
About how long
I've only got
this
two
place
green
has been abandoned,
for that one.
Essentially.
I've got two green.
You're as smart as I am.
Okay.
Against what?
Just one purple, I guess. That's fine.
Okay.
Not too hard.
Just like general knowledge.
Yeah, you're just kind of looking around at stuff. Yeah.
Well, I know nothing. But wait, I get some advantage.
Advantage.
Could have been here a day. Could have been here a thousand years for all you know.
But the advantage is...
Anything towards a thousand years!
But yes, you do have advantage. So, how about you notice some other details?
Yes.
Great.
I noticed some other details.
So you guys are all standing outside of the ship at this point? I take it? Is that true?
I'm okay with that.
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
I'm just trying to think of how to frame it.
I'm okay with it.
Okay.
Well, while you figure that out, I'm going to go into great detail discussing about how my ship is much, much bigger and has a lot more bang-bangs.
I'm
going to
tune out.
Okay. Yeah. So you guys...
It goes a lot faster.
Your guys' headaches have, by the way, kind of abated finally from your mind swapping. So you guys have kind of descended the ramp. You're standing here in this place. There's that one ship just sitting there. It's just like a very simple... boxy, unsexy little transport vessel.
I'm gonna scan for danger because I'm a bounty hunter, so I'm like constantly on the alert.
You can't really pick up anything by looking at it, but your advantage is that your other senses pick up like a deep thrumming coming from somewhere within the station and a distant sound of like a bestial groaning.
Okay, I'm on board with that. I'm gonna quickly set up a rope trap over the door to our ship so that if anyone tries to sneak on and it isn't us, we'll catch them and hang them upside down by their legs.
I like it, of course, the standard rope trap. I'm not gonna make you roll for that now. I'll make you roll for that if something triggers it. Okay, awesome. Is anyone else taking any precautions? You're scanning, looking for danger. Great, I'll give you boost dice if danger show up.
I'm being very, very careful to make sure that as soon as this mission is done, I get to keep the ship.
You're being very careful to make sure of that?
Yes, yeah, so I'm like talking with the general, and I'm like, so after this mission.
Sergeant.
So lieutenant after this is done. What are your plans for this? I can think of a couple of modifications and upgrades that could be made with this, and it won't be as good as my ship, but it'll be a lot better than it currently is.
Sure, I'm thinking, it should have, like, you know, instead of having to rely on collars, the chemicals should be injected directly into the air system at my own whim. I think that would be an excellent upgrade. Just because I don't get a blast of the happy gas when I want it, you know, I'm so jealous. But you want another one?
Just saying, we might go into some danger when we're walking into this spaceport. You might want to keep your hands free for, like, blaster pistols. You want to hand me that controller?
That's a really persuasive argument. Let me think about it. There should be a rule for that.
That is pretty persuasive. I will take persuasion. Do you have anything of that? Negotiate, I believe it's called.
I have negotiation.
I'm sorry. Being true to my character, I don't think you should give her anything. She doesn't know how to act whenever she has heavy weaponry or anything.
That wasn't me. Mm-hmm.
It was your trigger happy finger.
This is a difficult decision for me because in one case, objectively, you're right. And then on another case, that meal was delicious. So I'm not really sure who to side with here.
The door to the, yeah, I don't know.
No, dice rolls.
I don't know. That's a great question. I would take a dice roll from somebody, or I would just take that as role playing. I don't know.
Okay.
Or
would it be skullduggery?
That sounds pretty good. Skullduggery. So you're really trying to get it from them. So I'm going to make a roll from you, but I think your advice is going to do some, make it a little harder. Uh-huh. Okay, so that sounds good. So let's do negotiate. I think you're being very clever. Or charm, whichever of those are better for you.
Negotiation is 3 green and charm is 3 green. So
okay, so it's about the same. 3 green is not terrible though.
Yeah.
Okay.
And how willing is this guy to part with this device?
Well, I would say like what is a charm versus your cool, or is it your?
I would take discipline or cool. Yeah. Charm is against cool.
Okay, charm is against cool. So unfortunately, I think that's. If we're using Gippy's sheet,
yeah,
which makes as no well. Sense, is 4 purple.
That seems about right to get this.
Do it.
This
try one, it. Oof, all right.
Gippy's very
because
cool.
Technically I've already kind of tried. So.
Your advice, I feel like, was very true to your character, so I'm going to give you a black setback, and I'm going to give you a floating boost because I thought that was good role playing.
Thank you.
Okay, and I've got all black, so I better give you guys at least one white die on the board. So let's flip that open.
Louise.
And yeah.
Drop a purple.
Roll
drop a purple. Yeah.
And drop purple. So drop you're rolling 3 purple and a red against 3 green.
Mission abort.
Mm-hmm. And a setback die.
And a setback die.
Okay.
We're gonna do this.
Yeah.
I'm willing this to come out for us.
Let's get that remote. Oh, that's offset there.
Joey, you think you need to re-roll that one?
No, it's coming up blank.
Is it coming up blank?
Yeah, it's
coming
up blank. It looks like a threat to me.
Well, so maybe we need re-roll that.
Yeah, okay, let's re-roll it then. We've got a disagreement.
Blank.
Oh, it's a ton of failure anyway. That doesn't help you very much.
All right, I'm going to leave that remote alone.
5 failure.
A lot of failure.
Threat?
Against 1 success.
But a lot of advantage.
1 success and 3 advantage.
So you trust him even? You trust each other even more now?
Apparently, you just won't give up that remote. I'm gonna leave it alone.
So how about
at this
maybe
point.
Your failure is? She makes a good point.
Oh no, yeah. Advantage.
You're gonna want to have your hands free, so maybe you tether the remote to yourself so you can't accidentally drop it.
That's good.
Oh my god.
So you really have that
went
now.
Completely the other way.
Yeah. And but you definitely trust her. She's thinking.
I'm gonna strap it to my chest right here. Look at me, I'm Darth Vader. Except I can kill you with my mind too. Except I have to use my finger.
Oh gosh. Thanks.
Please
thanks for that.
Understand.
It's a little difficult to see which button wrong. I'm pressing now, though, I gotta admit.
This is practically, he's wearing it as armor now. Something happens to him.
That is our job, to make sure nothing happens to him. He's our liability.
My job is to kill who we came for. That's my job.
the door to the...
Oh, how do you cut through this tension on this thing? Oh, no, that's the kill one. Not going to press it. I'm just doing George W. Bush.
Like, yeah,
or doing... George Bush at this, or River Walker Bush at this book. I gotta die.
So the door to leading into the rest of the complex beckons. I think a marching order would make sense if you guys are...
I'm behind you.
I'm right in my right core.
I'll lead.
Did you roll threat on the negotiation roll?
It was advantage.
Oh, it was advantage. Okay, so then no, I'm not right in front. Like,
you wouldn't be? That's a good question. Who would be in front? Did we say that?
I prefer to be in the back, but I'll be in the front.
You are technically the leader.
All right, I guess.
But you do trust her a great deal.
That's true. So, your call. Whatever you want to do.
Well, since you're wearing that Ramona's armor now, I'll go in front of you.
Okay, so Maharaja takes the lead.
Smart as a whip.
Maharaja Gippy, Johnst.
Okay.
Sergeant Johnst, you're second, I have a feeling. And then back, rear, or?
No, I'm directly behind him to make sure that nothing happens to him.
That puts you in the rear on the Rancor.
That's fine with me.
Okay.
That way I can
We're
see
practically
you going to eat first.
Squad now.
Yeah.
Not me. I'm going to live through this.
So you come up to the door open panel. You hit the button. Beep, beep. Does not open. Beep,
oof. Beep. I wish my data pad worked.
But a little muscle.
Yeah.
Start to force it open.
Could use some help.
Oh, gotcha.
Right.
Get that big monster to just go ahead and just go right at the door.
You're telling me what to do?
Can we not?
Yes. Can we just
Here's
do?
Here's what we're going to do. What Yerp and I are going to do, because we're psychically connected now, is that we're going to, like...
That's a strong phrase, but you certainly read each other's looks very well.
We're going to, like, bro it. We're going to do, like, we're going to do some bro posturing. Okay. We're going to kind of, like, walk past him and be, like, right in his face.
Okay.
And then walk past. And Yerp is going to be like, oh, is this hard for you?
Yerp sticks his claws in. Door slams open. And as it does, a tidal wave of fluid flows out.
It's not.
We've all seen The Shining.
Yeah.
Elevator doors opening, blood. Except instead of blood, it seems to be like saline solution. Conceivably something. It's really hard to say what it is. Maybe it's something. And it's a ton of it. Come out with the force of fire hose that was as wide as a car garage. Probably overstating it, but you get the effect. Like a river. Slams into you guys.
Agility check?
I would take athletics.
Athletics.
Athletics skill from everybody to avoid being swept away. And by swept away, I mean swept back into this hangar. Ooh. By swept back into this hangar, I mean inexorably pushed back towards that electrostatic wall that is the only thing between you and outer space.
Oh,
what
goodness.
Is difficult,
Guess
my friend?
What? Yeah.
Four purple.
Shit.
Yikes. That's a lot of liquid.
It is a lot.
All right, I'm using Yerp's brawn, because I'm on top of Yerp.
Okay, that makes sense to me. And I better burn some dark side points on this, so dark side point on yours. Turn one of those purple to red, so that's three purple and a red.
Try it. Bring your noise. God damn it.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Immediate despair.
Success, though.
With a success.
With a success.
I totally succeed at this.
So you managed to hold your ground. Yerp is standing there as this fluid is blasting all around him.
Uh-huh.
But the despair.
There's a metal bead in the liquid that goes right through.
I like that. There is, it's like a big metal spar is like turbulently washed out and comes slamming right into the two of you. I'll let you choose. Do you want to take the critical wound, or does Yerp take the critical wound? Critical injury. Think about it. Over to you, sir.
I have a question. I didn't spend the bonus die that I had on the ship.
You can use it now, or you can hang on to it longer if you like.
Okay. So,
how much is there in this place? It's a huge amount.
So I have to dodge this with three green, so I'm going to use my boost die.
Both do boosts. All right, sounds good. Oh, that you're talking about the boost you got from his leadership role.
Yes,
that's fine. Go ahead and use it now.
Did I use that?
Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
Oh, you used it on your computer.
Oh, my gosh.
That was the leadership one?
But okay. You barely made it.
Did he succeed?
He succeeded. Because that's cancel out and leaves one success. It just also
is
leaves
a
two
ton
threat.
Of threat. Oh, no, it's only two threat?
Yeah.
Two you succeeded with two threat against that? Oh, I forgot to spend a dark side point. That's why it was easy for you. That's fine.
I know how it is.
Congrats.
When you're stronger, you invite.
Can you describe how you are not swept away by this tide? So I think you're basically right next to this rancor when the doors were open and you caught the full flush of this thing. We'll say I didn't upgrade that to a red, so we'll say you were maybe slightly behind the rancor.
Yeah, I took that.
Okay, well, after getting that dirty look, I jumped off of the rancor to purposely dodge everything as everything was coming forward at him.
Okay. Great. So I think this is a good point for me to...
Is there some kind of despair to drop on people?
Uh-oh, there's...
I feel like there's a despair.
There's something coming.
Despair.
What did y'all do?
Before?
There is. Is this the time to use it? This is the time to use it. Darth Sci-Fi Trek.
Dadgummit!
Little wink for you at the camera there. Drops a despair on Valerie because he's so close to retirement.
Oh, no!
This is awesome. So you're fine, you're hanging on, so how are you, you're hanging on behind the rancor?
Yes, he like tries to like climb up and jump off of, like trying to show off, but being really terrible at it.
I love it, so you're climbing up and it's actually working out and you're getting soaked, but you're climbing up, and then that metal spar that either hits you or Europe.
I did have one question.
Yeah.
Because I had two critical wounds last time, are those still on me?
Yes. Until you can get extended time in like a hospital wing or a back to tank.
Then Europe has to take this, I will die.
Not necessarily. You might roll a 10, and you're only going to add 20 to it.
Nice try.
Okay.
How many characters will die in this session?
Well, that's a great question, because this is the conclusion of this giant five-episode saga that I've been telling, where I think after I'm done with this, we're going to jump forward in time to jump into, like, later universe. Things are, yeah, to, like... post Force Awakens and stuff like that.
Think of how famous you would be if you died.
I'm also looking forward to doing that because then I'd like to see characters' offspring and or relatives and things like that down the line because it'll all be in the same universe.
The little gimpy, baby gimpy.
Maybe.
It's true.
If the ship doesn't explode. So I have been increasing the lethality of this stuff. Anyway, that's neither here nor there. Europe is going to take the critical
wound. Europe is going to take that critical wound.
Okay, I think as an NPC, Europe will be less resistant probably to critical wounds than you are.
Meaning what?
Meaning that maybe will take him out for the rest of the game.
Should I clear this?
He won't be dead. He'll just be too injured to go with you. Yeah, go ahead and clear those. Think about it still. I'm cutting back to you. As this metal beam slams into possibly Europe or Root, possibly both of them, it comes over them. And then catches you full on. This metal beam, it's so much bigger to you than it is to Europe. You're swept off into the tide, and your despair is that you're borne away by this flood of fluid back towards the rear wall of the hangar.
My other death was so much cooler.
Your other death was awesome. Well, let's see what happens to the captain right now.
I've got
to
take damage, don't I?
Yeah, that's right. You should definitely take damage from that.
You got a despair, so it's critical.
Damaging. Yes, I'm going to spend, we'll see how that despair plays out in a second, because I'm going to describe something fun. So let's say take 8 points of damage from that, subtract whatever your soak is. Actually, in this case, let's call it strain, 8 points of strain.
I'm taking just 8 points of strain?
Mm-hmm. You're going to subtract your soak from it, and your soak is 4, because you're a tough guy.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, when I subtracted my strain earlier, I have a soak of 4, so does that mean that it didn't...
That strain was just... straight up
that was
guy
just like,
drilling on you.
Got it.
Captain, right. Or Sergeant Johnst.
Yes. I should be rolling for this as well, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm technically on David's side of the table, so I hope I don't roll well. Let's hope you're all free. No, I did great.
He's like,
two success, but with 3 threat.
Well, does that advantage? I'm sorry, I'm still learning this. Oh. The advantage cancels out one of the threats.
Cancels out one.
Yeah. So I've got 3 threats.
Oh,
so
okay.
It's a success, a fairly strong success with 3
Sorry,
threats.
Just,
with 3 threats.
Still learning.
So I see this tidal wave coming, and I'm just like, oh, where's the strength adrenal? And I, like, hit it, and I'm just like, oh, yes.
just Hulk out into like.
I like that. I think it's
I feel like all the threat should rip the controller off of him and smash it into a wall and break it.
No, I like that strength adrenal thing.
I think that's great. I also think that those three threat are going to push the all the fooling around you've been doing.
Yeah.
It's not going to quite mind swap everybody yet, but the next time I get a total of three strain to come up, I think it's going to activate. So we've got a ticking time bomb.
Oh my gosh.
Oh goodness.
Or not three strain, I mean three threat.
I mean like,
oof.
I'm an NPC at this point. I don't care. That sounds great.
Yeah. Like,
okay, so and I just like just rippling thighs, just all thighs. Like really actually nothing going up here, but I need to stay in place. So it's just like only leg day.
I think this you're gonna see a giant strain hit to you as well when that's over. Or how many threat did we have? Three? So take three strain from that, not modified by your threshold.
All right, still your pen.
Oh. Dom, can you ask a question to chat? This is something that will come into
play. Are you asking them right now?
Yes.
Oh. Oh, you can just look at the camera and say, hi, chat.
Dom, I'm gonna ask a question to chat. Hi, guys. And can you relay their answers to me when they start to come in?
Notes?
Guys, this will come up. This will come up to play later. But
you need a pen.
Yes, please.
Chat. What is?
Do you have a particular color?
Chat. What is the most awesome ninja weapon?
What?
Yes.
What? Do not give him an awesome ninja weapon.
We'll discuss amongst yourselves, and then Dom, if you want to send me some of their answers, but. What is the most awesome ninja weapon?
So the four of us have to have, like, in our minds what it is, and then...
Smoke bomb.
No, don't say it! We have to see if it... I don't know.
Don't say it yet, because you'll influence them. You're wrong.
Yeah, I mean, you're wrong.
I'm not upset. Because that's
I know, because I'm a bounty hunter.
That's true.
Okay, I have a question.
Yes.
About the critical wound that will kill me.
Yes.
If I just don't roll 100, it means my next critical wound I have to add 30 to.
Yes.
But if I roll an 81, I'm toast.
No. Not, well, maybe. Yeah, if you roll an 81, you could die. Let's see.
Have the creature take it. This is no.
That's just
it doesn't
cruel.
Matter.
He's so strong.
Creatures, join me in the afterlife.
Creatures are an
it's
end.
It's great here.
A means to an end.
Is 81
plus 20 would be 101.
Your life is
always more important.
No. You would only be horribly maimed at that point. There's some gradations to your death. So 101 would be okay. You really only start true. You only die like quick until when you hit 126.
Really? Okay.
Then make it. So that's why I got to do critical wounds to you.
Lose some legs. Get a hover chair. It's gonna be great.
Okay.
That's what you gotta do.
I'm gonna get to your decision in a second. The next time a total of three threat have come up, everyone's minds are gonna get swapped again.
Okay.
So before I have you roll your roll, I'm gonna describe what happens to you, because that's gonna have a bearing on that. So your roll just has to be surviving this flood.
And I have some stuff to say.
Things are slowing down as you guys look around. You are just being borne away, and then
just
this
going backwards.
This fluid is mounting up. Bounding up against this electrostatic barrier. If you were on the outside of outer space, you would just see an invisible wall with fluid getting deeper and deeper. You get swept up against it, and as the fluid begins to form enough weight and enough mass, it begins to seep through, pushing through like a pseudopod out into outer space.
Oh, jeez.
Beginning to form a bubble that's coming out into the cold vacuum of space. And that is what you're being washed along into.
No.
As the fluid continues to spill out. It's almost like a big bubble is going to be getting... let me see if I can explain.
Because like the force field is porous, so that's how...
Because spaceships can fly in and out. So it's like a strong electromagnetic field.
Okay, but... field is porous, so the liquid's getting out. So how would that affect us? Because we're too solid to get out.
If you get,
like, no matter how much liquid.
I don't think so. They've never really gotten into the Star Wars universe. I assume a person who wanted to jump out to that force field could go out through it.
Yeah, I kind of think it's opposite, because air stays in, but ships go out.
Yeah. So I don't really know how it works, but my thing is, I'm saying that if you if there was just a little bit of water inside that was starting to gather up on the floor against the wall, the field would be strong enough to hold that in. But once a sufficient amount of liquid has gathered, the weight is so much that once the weight has passed a certain point, the shield will fail and it will all just kind of flow out together. And in this case, I imagine like a big ball of fluid floating out into space. That would just be like, because obviously it's zero G, and it would just kind of like all come out together at once in like a big blorp.
So it's alleviating the liquid level as it's doing this big ball out?
It will, but at this point, not quite enough fluid has gathered up to go through the force field at this point. But you are being swept back against the force field right now by this flow of liquid, and there's a real chance that you're going to get, this is with your despair, pulled out into space. And there's also a real chance that you're brain then may get switched with somebody else. So this is why.
That look at me.
Thank you.
So your roll's very important, because if you roll a total of 3 threat, everyone's brains are gonna switch. Mm-hmm. But we'll see if that happens.